first things that strikes me about this gym when I come in here and see everyone is that it looks like there's a really good camaraderie between everyone.
Yeah,
here, you know, and they're all working hard, and you know, that's the sense of depth. I'm sure that's the what you're trying to instill into this.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, it's a very tough game at the boxing yard to give the rules. So the camaraderie in the gym, the crack space, you've got to train hard, but you've got to have the crack, haven't you?
We've got a good, great team of lads, obviously they all stick together, and with the camaraderie they all help each other along, no matter what level they're at. And obviously, you know, the more experienced fighters can help the less experienced fighters.
Roy, I've just been chatting to him then, I mean, decades in the game.
Legend, isn't he?
Absolute legend, he really, really is.
Absolute legend.
Many, many years to come as well, God willing.
Please God.
You know, what he's brought to this, and it's a Bredbury Boxing Club, but then obviously it's been named after him as well. Great thing for everyone to do for him. But, you know, just tell us a bit about Roy and his input over the years, and you know, what you used to know as your granddad.
He's his granddad, but we've got like a saying in the gym that he's got two daughters but 3,000 sons. He's helped a lot of us, including me, going down the wrong way in life and doing what you think you shouldn't be doing and what you don't want to be doing, and getting me boxing and doing whatever else. And then he's done 50 years of turning people's lives around, and that's what he has actually done, Roy. He's turned a lot of people's lives around, mine included, and a lot of other people's lives around. So we try and do the same by turning other people's lives around. But it's a great thing to do, boxing. It's a great sport. It takes a lot to do it. It takes a lot to be involved in it.
As I say, like, he's a proper old school guy. You'll never change it. What you see is what you get. If you don't like it, then he doesn't really care anyway. So it's one of them. He's pretty brutal, but you know, it works, and he's been doing it a long time. And obviously he's produced a lot of good boxers over the years, and it seems to be working. So we take bits of our own stuff, but we take a lot of his. He's taught us all, so that's the way he'll keep it going.
Well, I take it it's been around you all your life, boxing and
in
the Copeland family. But, you know, when did you first sort of realise boxing was for you, and how did you get into doing the coaching now?
I didn't really have a choice, to be fair. I was dragged out at Christmas, and Christmas days I was out running on wearing a flow, stripping weight, and he just used to drag me out of bed, go, right, before I could even walk, he had me punching punch bags and stuff. So I didn't really have a choice from the start. Obviously, I had a lot of amateur fights myself. My career come to the end. Now I'm completely past it, so I might as well go into the coaching. Now I just get knocked out on a regular basis, so I might as well coach instead.
You've got a lot to give, though. And yourself, Tony, you know, how did you first get into the boxing and first into this gym?
It's a long, long time ago, Roy, a long time ago. And like I said, I was not doing the right things in life, like a lot of people don't. Then Roy took me in, started boxing, so. And then, like I said, you start coaching, and then you try and put back in what you've got out from boxing, and that's the beauty of it, as you say, is putting back in what you've got out. That's what we're trying to do here. But the biggest thing here is we work very, very, very hard. We train really hard. And some of these lads are real, you know, real good lads. Jack Murphy, Campbell, Josh, Ben. I've had some real good, champions in the past, TV Bell, Tony Singh. I've had some real good kids. And it's just about putting back what you take out of the gym. I think the biggest thing it actually gives you is your own self-respect and respect for others, because you realise how hard it is, and you realise how hard it is. So however hard you've trained, however hard, how much have you put in, the other kid up, he's done the exact same. So you have to respect the man, you know, and it just teaches them a lot. Teaches them a lot of humility, really, and you know, and self-respect for everybody, and that you can't, you know, there's two types of people in this world. Arseholes and the people, and they come in all shapes, sizes, colours, creeds, and you have to treat people with respect. That's what boxing does. Boxing teaches people to treat everybody else with respect, and your own humility, you know. As a person,
it also gives you a great family, really. You know what I mean? These lads in here,
yeah,
are like children to us. You know, like, basically, they're like the brothers that I haven't got, but really they are my brothers. You know,
well,
no matter what, we look after these like our own kids.
The gym becomes your family, really, because a lot of people haven't got, you know, a big family sort of thing, or haven't got a great family life. As a young man, you don't sometimes you don't have a great.
They come here for like a
life as a young man, you don't have a good family life to be honest. So this becomes your family, this becomes your home sort of thing, and it's a great camaraderie. It's hard to explain. It's hard. If you're involved in boxing, it's just one of the things you can't not be.
Full respect to you two for what you're doing, putting back into the game. It's a brilliant thing to see, and long may it continue.
Thank you very much.